Hello and welcome. I guess I'll become accustomed one of these days to there being such a thing as the Jesse Helms Center. On the other hand, I'm genuinely grateful that those folks at Wingate College came up with the idea. Now, this idea was largely that of Dr. Paul Quartz, then president of Wingate College. Now, I won't belabor the subject, but you may be interested in how it happened. About midway of my third term in the U.S. Senate, I was astonished when all of a sudden 8 or 10 major universities almost simultaneously began pressing me just a little bit. Each of the universities, you see, wanted to be designated to receive my official Senate papers. And I recall surmising that this was happening, one, because they considered me so controversial, don't you know, and two, because I probably wouldn't be in the Senate much longer. As it turned out, of course, they were wrong. But that made me think about whom I did want to have the papers. And I wanted to be comfortable about my decision. I wanted to pick an institution for which I had a sense of personal respect and affection. Certainly, I didn't want the tons of my personal and official Senate papers to be hauled way up north and handed over to people I'd never heard of. In any case, one day the then president of Wingate College, Paul Quartz, stopped by to see me, and as he often did when he was in Washington on other business. And I always enjoyed visiting with Paul, just as I do with that remarkable gentleman who is now the present president of Wingate College, Dr. Jerry McGee, who has, incidentally, a sideline of officiating NCAA football games. And by the way, before I forget it, let me interject that I had the honor some years ago of serving as a Wingate College trustee, and that was during the years that the late, great Bud Smith was president, and what a great, great guy he was. Anyhow, back to that day when Dr. Quartz visited me. Just as he was leaving, I decided on the spur of the moment to mention to Paul that I'd always wanted to do something for Wingate College to try to repay, in part, a wonderful gesture of friendship that occurred back during the Great Depression of the 1930s. I'd just finished high school, and there was no money for college, and I had become resigned to not going to college. But one day, out of the blue, the president of Wingate College came to our home in Monroe and invited me to enroll at the college. Now, those were tough times. My father was chief of police of our little town. At one time, he was chief of police of both the police and fire departments. His salary was minimal. And I told the president of Wingate College that I sure did appreciate it, but we just didn't have the money. And I remember his gentle smile. He said, "We'll take a chance on you. Just come on." I did. And as Paul Harvey so often says, now you know the rest of the story. I'm proud of Wingate College, and I'm grateful to this great institution. And I feel the same way about Union County. And I never pass up an opportunity to brag about my hometown of Monroe. I think it was Dizzy Dean, or somebody, who said once that bragging ain't bragging if you can prove it. And we Monroe folks sure as heck can prove it. I'm so pleased that you dropped in to see the Jesse Helms Center. Make yourself at home. I wish I were there to sit down with you for a spell, but maybe we can do that another time. Have a good time and have a good day, and God bless you always.